All right, so I'm getting ready for a wedding that I'm doing as Gene Simmons. That I do at KISS by Monster Mini Golf. I already got started a little bit, as you can see. Let's see if I can face this a little bit better for everyone to see. This does take some time. All right, continuing on here. Probably won't be doing too much narrating, so I don't want to shake. Now the key thing to this is you're going to make a crap load of mistakes. Don't worry, you got plenty of time in the world to fix them. Plenty of time. Time is your friend when it comes to doing KISS makeup. I'm just doing the outline. It doesn't really matter because I'm going to take it all off anyway. If you're not too straight, it's okay. Like I said, you're going to fix things. Always going to fix things. I like doing stuff. Doing one side and the other side. Try to keep them as straight as possible. Now things they're not going to be perfect. Never will be perfect. Well, not even Gene Simmons himself does it perfectly. I don't know if you guys are like me, but I get the drunk, shaky hand. I base most of my stuff off of the Eddie Munster. You can hear the radio station playing in the background, and they're doing an announcement. See, I'm already not straight, but don't worry, I can fix that. I also use my eyes. Try to get this, like where my pupil, outer pupil is. And the beauty of this too is that I wear a wig, not this, but overall this, so if you do mess up, the wig can cover it up. Connect. Connect, connect. See, like right there, I probably won't be straight, but I'll fix it later. Right now, let's just get the basic parts of what you want. That's what I do on the outside. This. Come down, don't worry if you don't get a solid black line. You just want to know where you're going for later. Curve into the outer part of the eye-ish. I'm wiping because I was scraping white off as I do this. I'm also looking at a photo of Gene from right here. I'm not drunk, but I said it. I call it the drunk shakes. Very. I put a lot of things near my eye, apparently. Under the eye. I always mess up this one. Always do. I just will. Message. There. And you notice my around my eyes aren't white, because what's the point in putting white there, because I'm gonna put black over it. But my eyeliner from the day was already on there. It helps. I don't like using the clown makeup on my... Whoopsie, I already messed up. Don't worry, we'll get to that. The clown makeup on my waterline. left. Now this is what I find to be the hardest part. So I generally start wide and then slowly bring it in. I will again do that later. So starting wide, going down. Same thing over here. Yeah, see, I got a lot of space there, but I could, at the end, when we get closer to the end, there'll be more. I'll fix it. Always about fixing. You see, all my stuff kind of connects somehow. That's just how I do it. Now, like, that's not straight, but again, we'll get to it later. All right, so make sure. Get rid of that, I cleaned it off. Now, for all that hard work we did, we take some of the makeup off using a Q-tip. And you just scrape it away. Scrape it away, like so. Get away from my hair. You use a lot of these. You really don't go green when you're doing KISS stuff. Q-tips. The reason you do this is because if you put black over it, it's going to turn gray, and then you can still do it. It'll just take you longer because you're just applying more and more and more and more. But trust me, it helps out because the black. Because when we do the powder, I use baby powder, not clear powder, which is up to you to set it, because you don't want to touch it and have it smear. I don't perform on stage with this, but I do perform in front of lights, and I do get a little sweaty, so you don't want to get itchy. Go like that, and then, oh my gosh, you got black into the white, they turn gray, and it's this big smudge. That is not good. Again, go through so many of these things. Surprise, there aren't KISS Q-tips. Actually, there's not even KISS. There's KISS makeup, but they don't even use that. Like, it's just BS makeup, really. They use Stanley Clown White. I don't even use that. I use Benign Clown White, which is basically the same thing. I use the same with the black. You can't see that. There we go. Those are the two that I use to achieve the God of Thunder and rock and or roll. And this is how Gene does it too. Basically, he has his own little video on the YouTube. It's on one side. You'll see, like, in this area, when I go over the black, it'll be kind of grayish or something. And push. Just pushing it. See, if you don't get rid of these, you'll do a pool. Actually, it's working. But it'll mix together and make a gray, and you don't want that. Want the whites white and the black black. I find my biggest problem is with my eyebrows. Well, I have a lot of problems when I do this, apparently, but my eyebrows. When I powder them, they hold the powder up very well because I have a lot of makeup on it, I guess. See, we'll get back to that. Probably make it fatter, even things out. See, they're a little different. That one's pretty darn good. I didn't do the white in front of you guys because I was something came up and I just had to do it, knock it out quick. Okay. Get away from me. All right, so now what we do, you guys are gonna get a bit of a show for a second. Hold on, I'm still here. Still here. It's going to get very messy. Alright. Because it's time for one of the many, many powder bits. Okay, so we're done with these now. Get them in my little plastic baggie. Covering up things. Am I naked, Slade? No, I'm not. Just halfway. So half naked. Me. All kinds of love from Slade. Yay. I think I have a hair on my nose. That's okay. Alright, so. This is a baby powder. Now, I call this the money shot for baby powder. Take a little bit, pour it in a thing, cause you, gotta make sure it's open, of course. Start out by using a lot. And then, you know, little and little and little. But I find it's easy. Grab a powdering brush and then just go for the money shot and then clean up. Without a towel this time though. Mm-hmm. Just make a big old cocaine mess. And you can feel it. Not the cocaine. Just where is what's wet still. Not really wet, but what's not dry. And you just pop this bad boy on there. I find you pat. Just pat it, because you don't want to smear it. Because you already got some black on there. And you want to, you can see how it makes kind of gray. Hold on. Ooh, so good. Just pat and pat and pat. Now I have a goatee that I hide. It'd be a goatee though. When you're done patting more on, that's when you feel that it's dry. And that's when you can start getting rid of it. Now you see it all over me. Clean this up. Now Gene does his lips too. I do that, but I save that for the very, very end. This is good. And then that. And I really, really suck at doing lips. That takes me quite a bit of time. Well, more so than you think it would for lips, you know. Yeah, it's in my hair. Okay, it feels a little wet right there, so just gotta add your own sound effects. Oopsie. when you do it too, you can feel where it's dry. Now, I'm not saying the way I do things is the way to do it. If anything, I've had a lot of people help me out. I've looked on YouTube a lot. It's all about finding your own way, because I used to use water-based colors, and it's just, I never got the hang of that, because you use this, an after spray, and it just burned. I don't know, like, I have very sensitive skin. Okay, we're about good there. See all that? We'll fix this by making it fatter. Just a little bit. All the time in the world, just keeps saying that to yourself all the time. I have all the time in the world. I usually do this faster. When I'm crunched for time, I take forever and a day. All right, so you want a really thin brush. And again, just in case you scrape white off, which you will. Because we're not done powdering. Just because we powdered once doesn't mean we're forever done. Excuse me. That's all the baby powder. So, I'll do the widow's peak after I do the eyes, and we'll just move from here. Try to duplicate your lines. Usually want one good motion. Even if you don't get a solid line, so you can come back in and dab. Dab. There you go, see? I usually try to have a point, because Gene Simmons is bat wings, if you will, are just straight and pointy. Well, not straight, but yeah, very pointy. I don't know if you can hear the music in the background, but it's KISS music. To my two viewers, is Slade one? Is that you? One of them, Slade? I don't think so. She left. Slade left. To tell you the truth, I'm really not that much of a KISS fan. You know, music is mostly my thing. I'm a bass player for Zoch. But, you know, in Vegas, there's a lot of performers, a lot of people who aren't themselves, you know, not necessarily acting, but characters being other people. I like to think of this as my version of it. You know, I don't... Hold on, I gotta stop talking. By doing weddings and stuff, I like to think of myself as a Vegas performer as well. You know, I'm not on the strip, but I am definitely part of a Vegas attraction that certain people just freak out over. And the beauty of KISS fans is that they're nuts. They're fun nuts. And kind of crazy nuts too, but I get to bring people together in love, and I get to wear clown makeup and act like a selfish, fun demon. No, you won't be seeing my wedding today. I want to give the couple that I'm marrying their privacy. This is not about me. It's about them. But right now it's about me. Very Gene Simmons to say, right? I'll get to my eyebrow later. Takes time. Gotta have time on. All we have is time.
I want to put you with you.
For a second there, I almost forgot where I was. That would have sucked. I started out doing Paul makeup. I still do Paul. He's the one with the star over his right eye. And that one, I'll do a video for that one the next time I have one of those weddings. But sadly, nobody really wants Paul. They want Gene all the time. But I like Paul. I can relate more with him because he's like this game show host. And I'm the performer. And I'm always... ask my girl Slade, I'm always on. I'm always trying to get a laugh or make people happy. Slowly but surely it starts to come together as opposed to this. See? Fucked up. Very careful on the nose, even though you can fix it. Just sucks. Try to keep that straight line, or that point. There, see? Little strokes. And it's funny how, that's straight, but it's not. It's just how your face looks, or is made, or whatever. Fucking eyebrow. We'll get to that later. Let's move on. Keep on keeping on. Get rid of my little... Totally missed. Baby powder all over my phone. Aww. Sorry, I'm not talkative. Shit just got serious. These without having to put white on. You can put more white on, but it's hard. That. Grab that point, hopefully. Viewer, hello, Skokie G. I'm getting ready for a wedding that I'm doing as Gene Simmons, as I do when I'm not playing music. Hey. Was that nose part again? See, kind of messed up there, but I knew I'd probably do that. So I can now bring these closer. Just slightly. Proud of that line I just did. Okay. Now I have some baby oil for fun things. I'm just gonna paint my eyelid. Find if you get that just a little wet from baby oil, put it in your black. You can be kind of a little more precise, but also it goes on a little thicker. Really don't recommend doing it with a big brush, but apparently That just scared me, so go back to my little one. Do the same thing. Not too much, though. It's funny, I wear eyeliner every day, but I'm the only one who can do my own waterline. I can't have somebody else do it. Weirds me out. And I got weird eyelids. So whenever I wear eyeshadow, after I blink 20,000 times, it all scrunches up. So it really sucks when you're doing kiss makeup. Now, I notice Ace Frehley has that problem. So you ever see him on stage, well, can't now because he's no longer in Kiss. But back in the day when he had his spaceman makeup on, halfway through his show, it'd start bunching up. So if that happens to him, I don't feel so bad. Not to say he's a rock god. I actually give a shit about Ace Frehley. I was more of a Bruce Kulick fan of Kiss. He was their best guitar player. Tommy's good too, but I just like Bruce. Tommy is the current spaceman, many of y'all know that. Told you, I don't really care about Kiss, but since I do this, I know a lot about it. And I appreciate what they've done for music, I really have. Like, come on, man, Rock Roll All Night. Their stage antics, their performances are great, and they're 66 years old, well, at least Gene is, and I think Paul is too, but, yeah, it's awesome. See, not bad. Time for up here. Very blonde. I don't like to wash my hair, so I don't want the black in my hair. What you're hearing right now is God of Thunder, written by Paul Stanley and performed by him. This was the demo version. You guys didn't know that. No, I didn't go all the way up because I would be wearing a wig. That will hide it. Okay, now this looks pretty good. Pretty darn good, actually. Not done. I have to set it with powder. Okay. Comes Nat, he is the messy bot. Again. This time around, take a cocaine, just kidding, baby powder, put more in their little saucer, keep it close to you. Let this dry a little bit. And then, because you're gonna, I'm gonna set this again, it will turn gray. But if you just dab it on, it should be, it'll work out pretty well for you. Just sprinkle it on, because you can't pat it. Because if you pat it, you move the black into the white, and then you make a gray schmear. Smear. Not schmear, but smear. We will pat at one point. You can feel it dry. Just, I have my eyes cracked. Which I don't think that your powder hurts your eyes. If anything, it just dries it out. But so let it sit and sit and sit. Start tapping it. And if you do screw up, which you probably will, which I probably did, we can fix it. Just snorted all that thermos cocaine in my face, in my nose. Start feeling it. Start getting a little more aggressive on it. Still tapping or just whatever. You want to find out how moist your eyeballs are when you get powder around them. So you start getting it away. Pretty darn good, huh? Yeah, a couple screw-ups, but okay, I'll try to fix them. But again, I'll have a wig. I can hide most of it. How long have I been doing this? Should have started timing myself. Now, certain areas here and stuff, we'll just take with no makeup on, or a little bit that's still on there from before, just like go over it slightly. More so just like taking off, the baby powder with the brush this time as opposed to applying. You know, be careful, yes, there's makeup on here still, on the brush. But you want your black to be black and your white to be white. As you can see, I did just mess up a little. Now the way you fix that little mess up, take the end of the brush you were using, get your white back out again, quap, 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 and you use that. Just dab it. One mess up, exactly. Don't worry, we'll repowder. Right. See? That's how you fix your messes up. If you up here, same thing. If you use the end of this, you can be more precise as opposed to using a brush to where you might end up fucking up. So back to fixing the baby powder parts. Be careful, you got stuff on here. I need to try to get my You see what I mean by my eyelids?
Fix that by putting more on and powdering again and cleaning.
Okay, same thing.
Baby powder in, yeah. Slightly.
Something over your nose. How we fix the nose. Okay, widow's peak. And then we'll get your eyes. Try to keep it little. Let that sit. Or, especially for that mess up, get a good mount on there. Put it on and then keep tapping. Never just want to right away. Not right away. My eyes. Get a little more on there for my eyes. Okay, so I get rid of that. Now let's get rid of what we've done. Tapping. Always tapping at first. Good. Now we can brush. See, now we're good. I really should try clear powder and I wouldn't have this problem at all, probably. Oh wait, you're not done yet. You're darn right I'm not. Got to do my lips. Well, no, who am I kidding? I just basically use the same fucking brush for everything. So now. Remember I told you I suck at the lip part. No, you basically just do your own lips. I try to try to make do like little points up.
Gene doesn't do that, I don't think. He just
does he?
Eh, not really. Ace does. He does like big silver ones. And I kind of like that. But and then Paul does big old freaking duck lips. Excuse that, but napkin.
Make sure you go green, everybody.
Except for if you're doing kiss makeup, you can't.
Good tip for the ladies or the goths. Lipstick, baby powder. And it will not come off. Go all the way back. So you want any red showing. Thank you.
Making it a little thicker. There, I got the two tops. Oops. Two mountain tops. Now. Not yet. There we go. Now he does these little fangs. I'm not going to do that. I don't like doing that because I fuck them up. It's like, ugh. I don't know how I did that, but it's like so dumb when I do it. So we'll just leave it at that. Time for your money shot again. Booyakasha. And that is how you do the demon, God of Thunder, Gene Simmons makeup. Thank you, everybody who tuned in. I'm not going to put my armor on in front of you because got to get naked for that one. But anyway, thank you guys so much. Rock on.